Yes, good morning, students. So today we are going to continue with narration. I guess the last segment is left. Exclamatory sentences and optatives, they are left. So the other segments we've already done. Today let's start with the exclamatories or imperatives rather. So when What are imperative sentences? What are imperatives? Imperative sentence is a simple sentence where the expression of command, request, order, or suggestion is there. For example, let's go for a walk. Let's go out. Do it, please. Get me a glass of water, please. Right, these kinds of expressions are imperatives. Okay, either command or order or advice, request. So when we change these imperative simple sentences in the from direct to indirect, then there are certain changes in the expressions. We'll be doing that today. Okay, so write one sentence in order to understand like what we are actually talking about. My teacher said to me, work hard to succeed in life. My teacher said to me, work hard to succeed in life. So here, let's first notice like what kind of sentence is here. Work hard. The sentence is starting with work hard. It's starting with a verb. So the sentences which start like this, work hard, when they don't have a subject with them first, they are imperatives. When the expression is either of advice, order, or suggestion, then they are imperative sentences. It is simple sentence. But in simple sentences, it is imperative. So whenever we get a sentence which is starting with a verb, then the linker will not be either that. It won't be where, it won't be even WH word. It won't be if, it will be to. Here the linker will be to. In the simple, whenever we had simple sentences as assertives, then we used to use that. When we got interrogatives, then we got linkers either if, whether, or the WH words themselves, right? Now we got imperatives. Imperative sentences start with what? The verb itself. Work hard. Go there. Don't do this. Something like this they will be like. So when they will be starting with like verb, or when you feel that it's an imperative sentence, then take to as a linker. And this part will be the same what the expression is of. So work hard. If the teacher is telling you to work hard, what is the teacher doing? Advising you. So here it will be the teacher. Advised. So said to will change into advised. A-D-V-I-S-E-D. Advised me to, okay, to plus first form, to work hard to succeed in life, as it is. So the teacher advised me to work hard. That's it. So only you have to remember, like when the imperative sentence comes, then we have to use to here. Okay, write one more sentence. Hard work is a key to success. Hard work is a key to success, said my mother. Hard work is a key to success, said my mother. Hard work is the key to success, said my mother. Yes. Chand, you give the answer. Yes, my mother, when your mother is telling you like hard work is the key to success, what is your mother doing? She's advising you. Okay, she tells you to take milk, she tells you to take food, but when she tells you to like hard work is the key to success, she's advising you. My mother advised me to work hard. So when it was like hard work is the key to success, it was like hard work. Hard work is the key to success. Here hard is the adverb. But we have to use a linker as to. 2 plus V1. V1 is work, not hard. To work hard. So my mother advised me to work hard. Is that clear? Okay, it was like hard work is the key to success. So my mother advised me that hard work is the key to success. Got it? Now here, in this case, we won't be using to work hard is the key to success. My mother advised me that hard work is the key to success. Okay, so when your given sentence was hard work is the key to success, what would you say? My mother advised me that hard work is the key to success. Okay, write one more example like this. Run fast if you want to catch the train. Run fast, sit down. Run fast if you want to catch the train. Shouted my father. So what is father doing when he is saying like this, when he is shouting at the top of his voice, like run fast if you want to catch the train? What is father doing? Okay, Devita says he is ordering. Is it order? Order is like when one is sitting and the other is asked like bring a glass of water. That is order. Your father might also be going to catch the train. And a father himself might also be running. And the children might have been dragging slowly. So when the father would shout like, run fast. What is father doing? Is it suggestion? Is it advice? Work hard, better work hard. That is advice. The train is running from that side and you are like moving like a snail. Then when father is shouting at the top of his voice, run fast. What is father doing? Angry? Okay. Yes. Warning. Okay. This can be a warning or warning is when the other person is doing something wrong and you are warning him against something. Otherwise, it's okay. Warning is okay. Told every time. Telling only. Yes. You people don't understand your parents. Encouraged. My father encouraged us. Yes, now complete the sentence on your own. Don't go after words. Go after, yeah, meaning or expression. Meaning. Okay, Chand, give the answer. But why is Madhav not coming? Is Madhav there? Raise hand, Madhav, if you are there. He is not there.
Good morning.
Yes. Yes, children, one thing more. Let me first tell you, I have sent a link. It is an audio cum video. Okay, that there is a one audio cum video plus there is one link of Google. That is actually your listening skills assessment test. Okay, today you people go through, listen to that audio cum video, then you open the Google form and attempt that. Okay, and today you do this by all means and send me the screenshot of your this listening assessment personally. Is that clear? Why I'm saying personally? Because your previous those things are also there. Otherwise, I'll delete them first. And don't do the test before. At what time will you do that? 2 or in the evening? Will 8 o'clock be okay? So from 8 to 10, I'm giving you 2 hours. During that time, you do it. Okay, from 8 to 10, do that assessment anytime. And afterwards, I'll close the link. Is that clear to all the online students also? Today, do the online link. Don't do this earlier because only you have one chance to do it. Okay, if you do, so whenever you open it, do that. Do that. It's very simple, not very difficult, but yes, listen to it carefully. Okay, 8 to 10 would be the time. Then send me the screenshots personally, okay, not in the group. Or I'll give you the instruction before that. If I tell you like to send the things in the group, then you send there. First, let me delete your previous things because whatever I have to note down, I'll note. Then I'll delete your previous chat. Then you send the links, screenshots there. Is that clear? Okay, Chand. My father encouraged us to run fast if we wanted to catch the train. The father encouraged us, past tense, father encouraged us to run fast if we wanted to catch the train. Was that okay? Okay, sit down. Next sentence. My friend said, can I have your pen please? The most common, yes. Can I have your pen, please? Yes. Now, what is friend doing? Is he requesting? Okay. So, it is either requesting or asking for something. Okay. Asked for. Or say, or you can say yes. Dhavnesh, yes, give the answer. Yes, complete it. Kushi, yes, give the answer. My friend, this is what I told the previous class. Don't change the narration from complex sentences to simple. So when we say like, my father said to me, What was it? My friend said to me, can I have your pen, please? No? So it's okay. My friend requested me if he could have the pen. If he could have his pen. If he could have my pen. Sit down. Though it's a request, can I have your pen? It's a request, no doubt. But it's in the form of a question. Right? Chand, are you listening? So though it is a request, but it's in the form of question. So we will be using the same rule which we use for interrogative sentences. It will be, my friend requested me if he could have my pen. Got it? So my friend requested me if he could have my pen. The captain said to the players, the captain said to the players, yes, what will be the captain saying? Okay. Stay focused during the match. Okay, done. Anjay Jay Adhate, give the answer. Yes, the captain advised the team to stay focused during the match. The captain advised the players to stay focused during the match. Any doubt? Okay, now we are going to start the optative sentences. What are optative sentences? They are one of the simple sentences. Simple sentences are assertive, interrogatives, exclamatories, imperatives, and optatives. So now optative is a sentence where the wish is conveyed. When you wish for something, it is through the optative sentence. May God bless you. If I were a bird. Okay. What I'm saying, what are optative sentences? Optative sentences are the ones in which you convey the wish or desire for something. Okay, or when there is some blessing, for example, this, may God bless you. May you live long. If I were a bird, if I were the Prime Minister of India, something like this. Now everybody wants to be the Prime Minister. Okay, so optative sentence, the teacher said to me, may God bless you. So when you get a sentence like this, like may God bless you, may you live long, then what could you write? What would you say? It's a wish. It's a blessing. The teacher wished. It's not an advice, right? The teacher wished. Yes, now complete it. The teacher wished. John, hurry up. You think and write. I'll ask you later. You may have any other expression in place of wished also. Using wish is not compulsory. You can write any some other expression as well. What's your name? Pushkar? Yeah, one thing again, one more reminder. Those who have still not sent me their holidays homework, there are some children. Okay, some 4 to 5 children are there. They have not still sent me the holidays homework. They send it. Because now we are finalizing your marks for your PT1. Okay, that's why now listening assessment has also been given. Now out of 20, your marks will be final. Your holidays homework were for 10 marks. Yes. If you've not sent, then send it. Because our list there, we have marked the children as being absent wherever the things have not come up. Now we'll like finalize it. Though that was final, but still we are giving you warning because it's your board class. Each mark will matter later on. And without proof, we cannot give you marks. Because each and everything's folder is your, all folders are ready. Those students who sent me the holidays homework, their folders are ready in my system. Okay, without, and all those folders are deposited in the school's office as proof. So if you've not sent me your holidays homework, children, please do it. Okay, don't worry, I won't scold you. Okay, Anji sir. If you have not sent, then send it. If you think like I might not have seen it, but I told you at that time to send it to the group. Did I? Then, because I only observed basically the group. Okay. Then you send it again because it might have got cleaned. Yes. Nana, yes, give the answer. The teacher wished for me that God might bless me. That's okay. Yes. The teacher wished that God might bless me. The child said, if I were a bird, the child said, if I were a bird. The child said, bird, B-I-R-D. If I were a bird, B-I-R-D. You can write anything, whatever you want to become. If I were a bird. So what will be the answer? The child wished if he had been a bird. The child wished if he had been a bird. Or it can be simply the child wished that. Okay, leave it. Let it be like this. Now one exclamatory also write on the example. The child said to his mother, wow, what a beautiful toy it is. Wow, what a beautiful toy it is. I want it. The child said to his mother, wow, what a beautiful toy it is. I want it. So whenever exclamatory sentences are there, so first of all, the expression will be exclaim with whatever the expression it is of. The child exclaimed with wonder or joy, anything. The child exclaimed with wonder that it was a very beautiful toy. And he further added that he wanted to buy it. Okay, next sentence. The old woman said, the old woman said, may you live long, beta. The old woman said, may you live long, beta. Beta is very much an Indian expression, isn't it? So we should use it. May you live long, child. Something like this you can write. So what would be the answer, Pushkar? Yes, Garima, give the answer. Okay, think again, think about it again. The old woman wished that I might live long. Sit down. The old mother wished that I might live long. Yeah, what will you say about beta? Lovingly, you can add. The old mother wished and spoke very lovingly that I might live long. Okay? Got it? When somebody addresses you as beta or child or bache, it means the one is, that person is addressing you lovingly. So that old woman addressed, the old woman wished and spoke lovingly that I might live long. What's the meaning of sir or ma'am? Speaking respectfully, right? That's it. So that's it with the narration part. Okay. So we'll be starting with the other topics of grammar. Next week, your first revision test will be there. And we'll be revising all those topics there. So you people can come up with your own doubts.